talk about the Battle of Gettysburg, much of the focus is on the fighting, the troop movements, and the casualties. But sacrifices and heroics were still being made long after the armies left Gettysburg. News 8's Matt Barcaro takes us to one place that opened this summer to the public for the first time since the battle.
George Spangler probably never thought his barn in the Gettysburg countryside would become an historical landmark. He was just a farmer in 1863, growing crops for his wife and four children. But the Civil War not only came to his town, it came right to his barn and took over.
I stopped to the George Spangler Farm and the 11th Corps Field Hospital site tells that story that the visitors have not heard.
The Union Army picked Spangler's farm as a place to care for wounded soldiers, in part because it was more than a mile from the original front lines.
And so they thought that this would, you know, be a very secure place for this hospital. But as the fighting shifted on July 1st, it would place this hospital one of the closest to the main lines of fighting.
During the course of the battle, 1,900 soldiers, including some Confederates, limped or were carried to Spangler's barn. Their battered, bloodied bodies filled the floors, amputated limbs piled high, the smell of sweat and decay mixed with animal waste and feed still laying in the barn in the heat.
The hospital, we think of such organization and sterilization, and for those that would experience this location, it was chaos.
The Gettysburg Foundation knows of 7 surgeons assigned to the wounded here, but there were most likely more. They performed surgeries around the clock, outside the barn, and exposed to the elements, and many times worked in the rain. The account of one of the surgeons is a glimpse into the strain of the job.
He had grown unsteady. His hand began to shake, hysterical tears running down his face. The surgeon continued to say that it was more than human endurance could stand. That surgeon would leave his duties and not come back to the farm.
Next door, the wounded moved into the Spangler's house, forcing the family of 6 to live together in just one of their bedrooms, and the army took what it needed. Before the battle, George Spangler bought wood to build a hog shed, but instead that wood was used to make coffins for the 205 Confederate and Union soldiers who died at the hospital. They were buried in this field, and the leftover wood was used to make headstones for their temporary graves. One of the soldiers buried in this field was George Nixon, President Richard Nixon's great-grandfather. Months after the battle, the remains of the Union soldiers were disinterred and reburied at the National Cemetery. The Confederate remains were returned to the South, and that included those belonging to Brigadier General Louis Armistead. He broke through the Union lines at Pickett's Charge and was shot. He succumbed to his wounds at the Spangler Hospital 2 days later. The surgeons worked on the wounded at the barn for 5 weeks after the Battle of Gettysburg had ended.
These truly are the unsung heroes that treated many patients and ultimately saved their lives.
They eventually turned the farm back over to the Spanglers. In the 150 years since, the farm changed hands only 3 times, and the barn was kept relatively the way it was during the war. And thanks to that, it helps us understand the heroics performed behind the front lines and the hardships even the survivors endured. In Gettysburg, Matt Barcaro, News 8.
Spangler Farm hosts free tours through Sunday from 11 to 3.